The other story of the day that we've been tracking closely is this. In a landmark verdict that casts a long shadow on southern politics, Tamil Nadu's share of water from the river Cauvery has been reduced by the Supreme Court. Karnataka now receives a bigger share. No state can claim exclusive right to a river passing through different states. This was said by three judges of the top court, including the Chief Justice today. Now, many disappointed farmers in Tamil Nadu said that the cut in the state's share will reduce cultivation by 1 lakh acre. The 765-kilometer-long Cauvery River is also called the Ganga of the South and has been the lifeline for Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. The river originates in the Kodagu district in southern Karnataka and flows into Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Puducherry. So what next? Thankfully, it's been a day that's passed off peacefully. We've seen repeated appeals for calm as well. But how does this impact the politics in the two states? Let's get our panelists in. Joining us is Mr. Palani Sami. He's a supporter of the AIADMK. He's been a former MP as well. Mohan Daspai, commentator and chairman, Manipal Global Education Services, is with us. I'm joined in the studio by Brijesh Kalappa of the Congress, and Arvanan, DMK spokesperson, is also with us from Chennai this evening. Mr. Palani Sami, let me start by asking you. Now, the opposition, of course, is describing this as a massive failure by the AIADMK. This is undoubtedly a blow coming even as you're trying to consolidate your position after what happened in the R.K. Nagar bipoles. How much of a setback is it?
No, what it affects us is the reduction of the quantity. Earlier, in the interim order, we have been given with the 205 TMCs. Then the final order was about 192. But today, they have, by the Supreme Court order, they have reduced 14.75 TMCs. Definitely, that's a cause of concern that affects us so much. But leaving that apart, three, four decisions are, we have to welcome those verdict and the decisions. One is they declared that the river belongs to, it's a national property, doesn't belong to one state.
Right.
And the river water management, Cauvery water management board has to be set it up.
Right.
And that board will monitor the water distribution and all that. But the one lacuna in the whole judgment is they have not stipulated any time frame for the formation of the management board, because there the politics may take place. The keeping the elections in Karnataka in mind, the government of India may delay that process, which is because for June we need the water. So
okay,
it may
I'm
be better
get into
for
that.
The Supreme Court.
That's a good point. I'm going to get into the impact of the elections in Karnataka in just a bit, but quickly coming back to my first point, sir, about we've seen the opposition, DMK, trying to put the government on the mat, describing this as a huge failure. How do you respond to that?
No, we can't say it's a failure. See, we demand, originally the interim order was 205, and subsequently in the final order we have been given with 192. And today, 14.75 TMCs has been granted.
Okay.
Leaving that apart, yes, definitely that affects our farmers. We do agree with that. But we will overcome that. But the much more success portion is the board has been set it up. And what now we have to urge is, yeah, time frame has to be given.
All right,
and
I get you. I hear what you're saying.
Water,
I hear what you're saying. Mr. Sarvanan, come in here at this point. The AIADMK perhaps trying to look at the glass as half full. It may not be what we wanted, they're saying, but look, we did get the tribunal out of it, and there should be no scope for politics. But that's not what's happening as far as the DMK is concerned.
See, it is not about politics. This is about lifeline. You have taken away 14.7 TMC feet of water, which is approximately, as you pointed out clearly, about 100,000 acres. Where will those farmers go? If the Bangalore city is unable to, if the Karnataka government is inefficient to provide water for its citizens in Bangalore, should Tamil Nadu farmers be penalized? I can't understand this logic. And we are finding fault with the legal defense put up by the AIADMK party. When we were in power, we ensured that there is this 192 TMC feed. They went on an appeal. The AIADMK government went on an appeal in this.
Okay.
What did they achieve? They lost 14.75 TMC feed. And as pointed out by Mr. Palanisamy, definitely we are very skeptical. I don't think the BJP is going to shout against shout for or bat for a setting up of this Cauvery management board. It's not going to happen.
It's not because going to happen.
They are playing electoral politics.
Okay, it's not going to happen. Let me get Mr. Pai in.
They have a chance.
Let me get Mr. Pai in, who among other things has been doing a lot to keep the focus really on issues like water, like civic issues in his state, and especially Bengaluru in particular. Respond to that, Mr. Pai. The point that the DMK is making today, that if it's a failure of successive governments in Karnataka to ensure drinking water for Bengaluru, how can an other state pay the price for it? The Supreme Court, of course, had the final word on that. But on this issue, sir, how would you respond?
I think the gentleman should look at the constitution and read the chapter on the right to life. The right to life includes the right to drinking water. The Supreme Court is very clear. And what the Supreme Court said?
No,
please, let me finish.
Mr. Sarvanan, let me
finish. No, I heard so much from you. Let me finish, please.
Mr. Sarvanan, just let me finish. Make his point. Yes, go ahead.
Let me finish. Okay. Let me finish.
Yes, go ahead.
Let me finish. You don't have to scream like you're politics. Let me finish. Okay. And the right to drinking water is a part of the right to life. So the Supreme Court has given privacy to drinking water for Bangalore, 4.5 TMC, and that is very good. And that, I think, is very clear. The Supreme Court has also said in the judgment, I think, it says that 10 million TMC of groundwater arising out of the Cauvery has not been considered by the tribunal, which was a mistake of the tribunal. And the Supreme Court has corrected that. And that is what has been given to Karnataka to say they got excess water there because they got this groundwater, they're using it. And the third point is, the Supreme Court has said is an water flowing through state, a national asset. It is not Tamil Nadu's personal property.
Right.
It is not Karnataka's personal property. The gentleman from Tamil Nadu cannot say, oh, we lost water. It is not his personal property.
That is the whole problem.
That's what the Supreme Court has said.
Okay.
And the Supreme Court has adjudicated correctly, giving privacy to drinking water, correcting an error in the tribunal. I don't know why the gentleman should be so upset. He must compensate his farmers for having three crops. They grow three crops in Tanjavur, whereas in Mandya, we grow only one or two crops. And Supreme Court has done justice.
Okay.
I don't know why they have to be so abusive and deny Bangalore drinking water.
Okay, Mr. Sarvanan, I'll let you very quickly respond to that. And again, this comes down to something that the Supreme Court has said, which is what is being quoted by Mr. Pai, that, you know, water, river water is nobody's property, really, especially when the river is flowing through different states. So are you contesting that?
See, nobody can contest that. Nobody can contest. And Cauvery is giving drinking water to the entire basin also. It is not as though nobody is using it as a drinking water in the state of Tamil Nadu. We also use that as the drinking water. We don't use that only for irrigation. And again, I want to reiterate, if your politicians are unable to find solution to your drinking water problems, why do you want to take our drinking water only because you are an upper riparian state?
That is not your drinking water, man. It's a national river. It's not your personal drinking water.
Okay.
It doesn't belong to you. It belongs to India. Please understand logic.
We know it belongs to India.
Our drinking water is not your grandfather's property.
We don't need your lectures on that.
It belongs to India. And that's what Supreme Court has said.
And that's really the heart of the problem.
You are not the only person in India. Okay. Bangalore is in India too. Please understand. And the Supreme Court has said Bangalore is part of the Cauvery Basin. And the tribunal has not admitted the error of not including Bangalore in the Cauvery Basin.
Which was really
at
the heart of the problem.
Come and talk something.
Okay. I'm just going to get Brijesh Kalapa of the Congress. Mr. Sarvanan, just give me a moment. I'm just going to get Brijesh Kalapa of the Congress. Let's just take a look at politics of a different kind. We saw celebrations in the Karnataka Assembly today.
It's not personal property, this water.
Right. We saw celebrations in the Karnataka Assembly today, Mr. Kalapa. This is, of course, a big win for the Chief Minister of Karnataka. That's how it is being pegged. So, electorally, what do you think this will do?
No, I don't read this electorally at all. The issue is this, that as far as drinking water is concerned, it was also reported in the BBC that Bengaluru is one of the few cities in the world which is going to be seriously affected.
We are running out of drinking water.
And they compared us to South Africa's Cape Town.
Cape Town, right.
Where, you know, the drinking water shortage was so acute that rationalization had to be done and people were actually fleeing the city. So this was the circumstance under which this judgment has today come. And the point is this, that if one third of the city belongs to the basin, while the city has grown, but there is contiguity between the one third and the two third which is outside, the Supreme Court has considered it and said that certainly that part of the city which is not within the basin is permitted to draw water from where this the basin exists.
Right.
So to that extent, it's been a big relief for the state.
But you're still saying that electorally there's nothing to it. It's not that it's going to be milked in the elections or is a shot in the arm ahead of those key elections.
No, it may be we may present a good feel good factor that look there is a lot of good things happening, but Cauvery can't win us an election, can't lose us an election.
Okay,
I think
that's
we have to be very serious. Yeah, we have to be very serious about it.
Mr. Pai, would you agree on that? That you know there of course those after looking at those celebration pictures saying that this is a huge boost for the state government of Karnataka. How do you believe this will play out in the elections, if at all? Or do you agree with the Congress that Cauvery can't win or lose them an election?
No, I agree. Cauvery cannot win or lose the election because the election will be judged on merit for performance. Hmm. The Siddaramaiah government has done very well. And I don't think they should depend on the Cauvery to get a few votes. It's not going to get them a few votes. Mm-hmm. Because when the elections go on and there's a drought, people are going to remember the drought and not whether the Supreme Court gave you more water because there's no water. Mm. So I don't think they should push for that. I'm sure Siddaramaiah will focus on his achievements, what he has done. Mm. He has given a very good budget today. He has given farmers in dry land 3,500 crores as income support. Mm. He has given many, many good things. Mm. That may win him the elections rather than Cauvery. Mm-hmm. Now the celebration is just that after 50 years, it's finally come to an end. Justice has been done. Bangalore has got water. Mm. But in the whole, excluding the water to Bangalore, mm. I mean, there is not much of any injustice done to anybody. Bangalore is 1.2 crore people. They cannot move away. Mm-hmm. If 100,000 acres don't get water, you can compensate them by money. Mm-hmm. If 1.2 crore people don't get drinking water, you can't move the city and reallocate the city. It cannot happen.
Absolutely.
So I think we got to be balanced and praise the Supreme Court for giving a very good judgment after 50 years. Okay. They should be set to rest.
Okay. I just want to get everyone in on the tribunal. But before that, Mr. Salmanan, you want to make a point.
See, that's what the problem here is. They think it is, we have to give it to the Karnataka government and the political parties in Karnataka. They were in one voice. From 2016, they have been saying this, that drinking water is a problem, drinking water is a problem. We don't know actually whether it is a problem or not. They created this perception that Bengaluru is suffering due to water.
It is a problem,
but
you come to Bangalore.
Tamil Nadu, the political parties were not united. They were not, we did not even have to have an all-party conference.
Okay.
That is the biggest problem, and
yeah,
I think this had a very telling effect in the Supreme Court too.
Okay, one moment. You wanted to make a point, sir.
Yeah, I'd only like to point out to my friends from Tamil Nadu that today may appear to be a bad day for them. But I understand because we have also gone through several bad times during the course of the litigation. I'd only like to humbly point out that in the Krishna River water dispute, Karnataka is a party, Maharashtra is a party, and Andhra Pradesh is a party. Tamil Nadu is not a party. Yet, the three states, we give them 5 TMC each, and that's the water which goes to Chennai. So it's this spirit of national cooperation that is how the country can go forward.
Mm-hmm.
And if today Karnataka is totally water-starved, and Bengaluru is totally water-starved, I would only make a humble appeal to people across the border that please do understand us. Please don't impute motives.
But is that possible? Is that possible? And I take that to Mr. Palaniswamy. Is that possible? I mean, you're hearing your state politics as well. You're hearing what the DMK is saying. But the other point being made that we can just sort of work together. The states can work together. Water, of course, such a key resource. And now it's been made very clear doesn't belong to anyone. We heard Kamal Haasan say that too.
Different states can work together. Mm. But the problem is Karnataka should ensure at least whatever the quantity which has been fixed by the Supreme Court today, that should be ensured as delivered.
Mr. Pai, wrap this up for us. How do you see this going forward? What next?
See, 50 years of disputes, the Supreme Court has given an order. Both states should work together to make sure they work it out.
Mr. Pai, Palaniswamy, Mr. Salvanan, and of course, Prajesh Kalapa, thank you so much for your
time. Thank you.